Hello and welcome to the MAC weather page for this Friday, August 17th. And we got a pretty busy weather pattern. You can see outside this morning, a lot of fog here in the Breckenridge area. And it's very, very humid out there. Dew points up in the upper 60s to near 70, pretty close to saturated right now. And the air feels quite heavy out there. And if we look at the headlines, scattered afternoon thunderstorms are pretty likely across many areas. Again, overall, the general models are pretty painting out about 1/10 to 3/10 of an inch, but many models are also pointing out some areas could see isolated rainfall amounts over 2 inches. In fact, some of them even predict there could be some localized areas that could see up to near 4 inches of rain. But again, for the most part, I think everyone will get at least some more beneficial rain, and hopefully that'll get us closer to our storm total. And then we're watching for the potential of a pretty significant early fall storm coming in for next week, probably around Monday night into Tuesday and Tuesday night. And then we'll have a strong cold front come through the area. And out ahead of that, we could see some pretty significant rain. And we could see strong to severe thunderstorms and lots of wind with this system, followed by a much cooler and more comfortable air mass with maybe highs only in the upper 60s to mid 70s for much of next week. And if we look at yesterday, we had a high of 81 and a low of 66. We had just a trace of precipitation, a couple of sprinkles, but overall no precipitation here. But some areas did pick up rain yesterday, and we'll show you that. And you can see the normal high is 81, or rather the normal high is 81. Actually, the normal low should be 56. Sorry about that. And sunrise is 6:45 this morning, and sunsets tonight at 8:38. We lost 5 minutes of daylight since yesterday. And if we look at the latest drought index, you can see not a whole lot of improvement. Northeastern lower Michigan up around this area has certainly seen a little bit of improvement, but we expanded some of the moderate drought areas across different portions of Michigan. But again, hopefully we'll try to keep knocking down on that area here over the next week or so. And if we look at the storm total so far, you can see some of the areas picking up some of the rain. Look at that over at St. Thomas, over 1 1/3 inches of rainfall there. Our average is up to about 0.18 inches overall, and we're going to see that climb today. Again, some of these areas could see some very locally heavy rainfall, and we may end up closer. Now we got our winners from the Agro Expo rain gauge giveaway that I had, and the first winner is Brian Toes, and our other winner is Francis Teichman. Hope I didn't destroy that name too bad. But congratulations to you guys. We'll get a hold of you on where to ship your rain gauges to. And if we look at temperatures out there this morning, it's a very muggy with temperatures in the mid-60s, around 70. So about 10, 12 degrees above normal. So a very warm morning out there. And again, very humid out there as well. On the satellite view, you can see our upper lows back in Iowa. Again, it continues to move towards the Great Lakes. We'll have almost like a winter storm deformation zone you can see setting up to the north of that. And right now the outlook is for the heaviest rains to actually be in the southern part of the state from around Lansing area off to the south. But I would not be surprised, much like a winter storm, sometimes these early systems like to track a little bit back to the northwest, and we'll see how that pans out. But all areas should pick up some showers today. And you can see that on the radar as that activity continues to pinwheel around that. And this is kind of the deformation zone that's setting up. And again, we'll show you where we think the heaviest rains will fall today. And if we look at the weather map, low pressure system will be moving into Illinois eventually. Eventually, these cold fronts will push through the area as we go through the next 24 hours. And that'll lessen the opportunity. Can't rule out a chance of a shower or thunderstorm south of the secondary cold front, especially during the afternoon, if we can get enough instability. And then finally, by Sunday, high pressure takes control of the area. Sunday will be the best day of the weekend. Saturday will be a nice day as well overall. But Sunday looks like it'll be warm and dry and lots of sunshine. And then we'll get ready for the next storm beyond that. Again, this is the outlook. You can see in the next 30 hours over with the WPC, you can see 1 to 3/10 inches of rain is forecasted. But again, in this area here I've outlined, this is the area you can see some locally extremely heavy rainfalls, and it's centered across this area here from around the old port here on through Lansing and back towards South Bend. And again, anywhere in this area though, we could see certainly some very, very intense rainfall with any storms that move through the area. As far as extended outlook, you can see that trough trying to dig in across the center of the nation. Here in the Great Lakes, we're kind of right on the fringe of that. And that may also allow for above normal precipitation for both the 6, 10, and 8, 14 day outlooks. And certainly we could use the rainfall as long as it doesn't get out of hand. As far as weather watch this morning, you can see just some beach hazardous beach statements on the western end of Lake Superior. And we do have some flash flood warnings as you get south into Illinois. Again, that's where some really heavy rain continues to fall. As our forecast goes, again, just about a 50 to 70% chance of showers and thunderstorms this afternoon on a scattered basis, but any of these storms could produce torrential downfalls. And again, that chance, again, about 60, 70%. And then we'll see just a chance of a thunderstorm. I didn't even include it, but just a slight chance of a thunderstorm during the afternoon, highs in the low 80s. We'll be in the low 80s on Sunday with lots of sunshine and maybe mid 80s, maybe even warmer, depending on how strong that storm is. It could pull a lot more warm air up into the area. Right now we'll go for low to mid 80s. And then we're going to watch, I think, that big storm as it comes in Monday night and Tuesday. Again, it's not a sure thing, but it's something worthwhile because it could produce some rather strong to severe storms, lots of wind, followed by a much cooler air mass for the middle and end of next week. Thanks for stopping by and have yourself a great day, a great weekend, and 73s to all.